Now let's talk about placement groups. Placement groups are a little bit more advanced, and we want to use them once we want to have control over how our EC2 instances are going to be placed within the AWS infrastructure. So that strategy can be defined using these placement groups. So we don't get direct interaction with the hardware of AWS, but we let AWS know how we would like our EC2 instance to be placed compared to one another. So when you create a placement group, you have three strategies available for you. You have the cluster placement group, in which your instances will be grouped together in a low latency hardware setup within a single availability zone. This is going to give you high performance, but high risk. We'll see this in details in a second. Spread means that your instances are going to be spread across different hardware. And that is a restriction on this. That means you can only have 7 EC2 instances per placement group that's spread per AZ. So you would use a spread placement group when you have critical applications. Finally, the last one is a new kind of placement group that is really helpful. It's called partition. It's similar to the spread, meaning that you want to spread your instances, but here they're spread across many different partitions. And these partitions rely on different sets of racks of hardware within an AZ. What does that mean is that they're still spread, but they're not isolated one from another failure, but a partition should be isolated from another partition of failure. The idea with this is that you can scale to hundreds of EC2 instances per group, and that allows you to run applications such as Hadoop, Cassandra, or Kafka. Now let's have a look into each of these placement groups in details. For cluster, that means that all our EC2 instances are on the same rack, which means same hardware, and it's in the same availability zone. So as you can see, all these instances are on the same hardware. And so why would we do this? Well, basically we would place them on the same rack because we want to have a cluster, we want to have super low latency, and want to have maybe a 10 gigabytes speed network. So that means that we have an amazing network, right? But as a drawback of this great network that we get the crown that if the rack fails, if there's a failure on the hardware, then all the EC2 instances will fail at the same time. So we have increased our risk to have a failure that's going to be propagated across our entire stack. So when would we even use this? What's the benefit to getting this increased risk? Well, we get great network. And so for this, that means that we can have a big data job that we'll need to complete very fast. Or maybe we have a requirement to have an application that needs extremely low latency and high network throughput, and we're willing to take on the risk to have this failure. And so this is something you have to realize. It's not for every kind of application, but if your application needs super high bandwidth and low latency, placement groups is kind of a nice, the cluster placement group is kind of a nice way of doing this. Now, spread is the complete opposite. In spread, we want to minimize the failure risk. And so in this case, when we ask for a spread placement group, all the EC2 instances are going to be located on different hardware. So as you can see here, we have 3 AZ and we have 6 EC2, and each EC2 instance is on a different hardware. So what does that mean? Well, what we get is that we can span across multiple AZ, and there is a reduced risk of simultaneous failure. Why? Well, because if my hardware 1 fails, I'm pretty sure my hardware 2 will not fail. And so we've separated the risk of my 2 instances in the US East 1A to fail at the same time. And so that's the benefit from it. The con is that from this configuration, we're limited to 7 instances per AZ per placement group. So there is a limit to how big your placement group can be. And so you need to have an application that's going to be of good size, but not too big. The use case would be an application that needs to maximize high availability and reduce the risk. And in general, for critical applications where your instance failures must be isolated from one another. Remember, here we have a limitation of 7 instances per AZ per placement group. Now for the partition placement group, within the AZ, we'll have different partitions. So partitions are a set of racks. And so we have here in this example, 3 partitions, but we can create up to 7 partitions in a partition placement group. So on each partition, you will have different EC2 instances. So in this example, I have 4 EC2 instances per partition. And here we can see that within a partition, all these EC2 instances could fail together, but across 2 partitions, there is no failure that's shared. So this is why you would have partitions and an application that can tolerate a whole rack going down as long as your data is as well partitioned. So what can we know about this? Well, there's up to 7 partitions per AZ and up to hundreds of EC2 instances as part of that placement group. And that is the difference versus the spread placement group. The instances in a partition do not share the racks with the instances in other partitions, and therefore a partition failure can affect many EC2 but won't affect other partitions. EC2 instances can get access to the metadata representing which partition they belong to, and the use cases for this kind of setup is going to be for distributed big data application usually, so HDFS, HBase, Cassandra, and Kafka. All right, so let's have a look in the UI about how we can create placement groups. So let's go ahead with creating our first placement group. For this, the menu is on the left-hand side. Under Network and Security, you will find placement groups. Create a placement group, and the first one is going to be called My High Performance Application. And because this is a high performance application we want to create, and I just named it this way, I want to use the cluster strategy. Remember, cluster groups my instances together so that they have high network communication between the two of them. So here we go. I've just created my first placement group, which is a cluster placement group. I can create another one, and this one, for example, will be my critical application. And it's critical because I want to run it as a spread cluster. And here, our applications are going to be spread out as much as possible. But remember, we can only have 7 instances per spread group. Okay. And finally, I will create one last one, my distributed application. And this one is going to be a partition strategy. And I have to select the number of partitions. And the tooltip tells me that the maximum number of partition is 7. I will just go ahead and create 3. Click on create. And here we go. We get some information around all the placement groups we have, but how do we use these placement groups? Well, for this, we'll go to instances and launch an instance. We'll create an Amazon Linux 2 instance, and we won't go all the way with creating the instance, just to show you the option. I'll select a T2 micro, click on configure instance details, and here on the left-hand side, there is a placement group, and I can tick the box and add the instance to a placement group. Here, I can create a new placement group or add to an existing one, but we'll choose one that's existing. So we could select spread, and spread allows us to launch up to 7 more instances into this placement group. So there will be 7 of them will be spread out across our AZ. There will also be partition, and here we can specify the target partition we wanted to, 1, 2, or 3, or we could have an order distribution if we wanted AWS to try to equalize the partitioning of our EC2 instances. Or, as you can see, cluster is not showing up because cluster is not available for T2 type of instances. So if I select something a little bit more, something like M5A24X large, and I'm not going to launch it, obviously. So I'll say, yes, I would like to continue with this. And I'll say, okay, and this time you're going to launch it as a cluster. And so the cluster placement group right now is available only for instances types that are quite high. So here we go. I could select my cluster type. And we'll be done. So that's it. This is how you would assign an EC2 instance to a placement group, and you can create many EC2 instances within a placement group. And then you would click on review and launch, but we're not going to do this because I don't want to pay for an M5A24X large, okay? But at least I hope you understand how placement groups work and how we can use them through the console. Hope you like this lecture. I will see you in the next lecture.